In a sleepy suburb of Birmingham live the Browns. Mum Jackie, Dad Stuart, and their daughters, 14-year-old Lucy, 12-year-old Charlotte, and 8-year-old Beth.
Let's go.
The Browns are mad for the great outdoors. On weekends, they jump into his and hers 4x4s and head for the hills.
We're not a social family. We like to keep ourselves to ourselves, and we like to just be out in the woods on our own.
Their annual vacation is a survival holiday in a remote area of Scotland, miles away from civilization. They build their own shelter, source their own water, and skin and gut animals to eat.
We love survival holidays because you're out in nature. When it's raining, you just want to be out there, getting wet.
Oh, can you see that sparrowhawk over there?
Our holiday requires a great deal of mental and physical preparation beforehand. We turn the radiators off about a month before to acclimatise.
Morning.
Temperatures can reach minus 10 on a survival holiday, and acclimatisation is something the whole family takes very seriously.
The hardest thing about our holiday is sleeping, because of the cold, you can't kind of get to sleep.
There you go, Mrs.
I would think most people would hate our holidays because there's no flushing toilets, no showers, no beds to lie on, and it's hard work.
A warm hat?
Yeah.
First aid kit?
Yeah.
Packing must be done with military precision.
Sharp knife?
Yeah. Yes.
One of the most important things in survival, obviously, is a knife. Starting with the biggest first, obviously. We have a machete.
The Browns' family motto is always be prepared for any eventuality.
Toilet roll.
Got it.
We keep our survival kit packed at home. Because you just never know with a natural disaster or even a civil disturbance. Hopefully we would survive with the skills we've learned.
Basildon, Essex, home to the Maybes. Dad John, Mum Sharon, 16-year-old Jade and 17-year-old Bobby. They're loud and proud of it. Their free time is spent socialising and drinking copious amounts of alcohol.
We like package holidays because everything's done for us.
He's like ringing out the table here. It's a bit natural, for sake.
Holiday for me is total relaxation. I like to sit by the pool or the beach all day.
Sunbathing, relaxing, going out of a night time.
Just drink and party, stay out till late.
Lanzarote is the Maybes' holiday destination of choice because there's sun, 24-hour drinking, and they're never far from their home comforts. The Maybes don't do back to basics. They pride themselves on a comfortable lifestyle and keeping up appearances.
I would say I spend about 4 to 5 hours a day cleaning. When I see dirt, it's got to be clean there and then.
Towel. Here's a towel.
John is quite a vain person. He loves walking past the mirror. He takes longer to get ready as well than I do, pruning himself.
Done.
Daughter Jade, who is studying hair and beauty, is a chip off the old block.
Every morning I spend about an hour getting ready to do my hair, makeup and dress.
People who don't spend a lot of time on their appearance won't get anywhere in life.
The Maybes are very particular about their food, especially the kids. There's a lot they don't eat.
I've got 4 very fussy eaters. So, as you can see, 4 different meals. This is a pain.
Best thing about Mum is she does everything for me, like she cooks and cleans for me. The towel I got about 3 weeks ago. It's of my mum.
I have to take the iron, because everything's got to be re-ironed again when it comes out the suitcase.
With no idea she'll be sleeping in the woods, Sharon does some last-minute optimistic packing.
Must have my hair straighteners. My hair's got to be straight at night.
We would be concerned about anybody coming on this holiday who hasn't prepared mentally and physically for it.
It's the first day of the holiday, and both families are raring to go.
Let's go!
Let's go!
I'm going to leave you here, but let's go.
The Browns head straight for Scotland, while the Maybes set off to the airport, where they receive a text message telling them where they're going.
Oh, what's a message?
Is that it? Is that it? Here we go.
Hi, there we are, the Brown family. Come and join us for an adventure in Scotland.
Knew it. Oh, knew it. Scotland.
The Maybes have arrived in the wilds of Scotland, an area known for its outstanding natural beauty.
It's freezing.
It's cold, it's overcast.
You've got the same weather as what you got at home. What's the point of that?
This is where the other family come for the holiday, then. A bit sad, really.
This is my worst nightmare.
Oh, they're all army geared up. No, do us a favour. You're having a laugh. Got to pick a warmer place, can you?
Stuart Brown. Yeah, with the Browns, yeah.
Brown, nice to meet you.
Once the pleasantries are over, Stuart Brown drops the bombshell.
We're going to be doing a four-day survival course.
So what are we actually camping out, haven't we?
There's no tents. We make our own shelter. It's good fun. It is good fun. It's a good laugh.
I'll tell you, no, it's good.
Any hot toddies by the campsite?
That is one thing. There's no alcohol permitted.
That's good. Okay. Jade, you have to lose the handbag, girl.
I think the other family's really nice. They seem up for it. And, they look like they're...
Yeah, I think we have a good laugh with them.
They may walk off, but that won't really matter because this is what we like to do as a holiday.
To guide them through the next few days, the Browns have enlisted the help of an ex-army survival expert, Alan Finlay.
This is Alan.
You can't look, because I know where you live. All right.
This is a bit daunting on you, so you've just been dropped in it. Yes. Yeah? You're not using tents, you're not using conventional cookers. Your food's what nature provides.
Treading it? God, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Where are you going to plug your air dryer into?
Going to the toilet.
Oh, that'd be all right.
What about you?
Twice a day.
To reach their final destination, there's a gruelling 4-mile hike from base camp.
There's better things in life to do.
To the Maybes' horror, they'll have to carry packs weighing over 30 kilos on their backs. Jade Maybe doesn't get off to a good start.
Oh. You're right. Yeah, Jan.
As the Browns effortlessly march ahead, Sharon Maybe is struggling.
It's my worst nightmare, and I hate walking, especially uphill. I hate it. Now, don't let me stop while I'm on a roll.
This isolated area of woodland, miles from civilization, is the Browns' idea of a holiday hotel. Water is what the nearest stream provides, the toilet is a hole in the ground, and for tonight, shelter is one small parachute.
Oh my God, I can't believe I'm going in the forest!
They've arrived at camp, but with darkness quickly approaching, there's no time to lose, so Stuart Brown sets a plan of action.
So we've got to get water, we've got to get a bench to sit on, we've got to get some timber for the fire, so...
I'm ready when you're ready, mate.
It's not long before the novelty of being in the woods is wearing thin.
I'm not looking forward to tonight because of animals and stuff, and you can't change or nothing. I need to wash my hair.
I was just worried about Sharon and Jade. They've got long nails, and Sharon spent 60 quid having her nails done before she came away.
I'm getting very dirty and tired now. He's okay at the moment, look. Minus 10.
We're just going to keep feeding the fire just to make sure it's...
It's all right for some, this type of holiday. It suits some more than others. It's not my type of holiday, though.
Don't like to drink like that.
No, it's disgusting, don't it?
For Jade, the full horror of the next few days begins to sink in.
Is there milk?
Powdered milk.
What, you've got powdered milk?
What, powdered milk? No.
I've never... What's powdered milk?
Jade, it's nothing. It's just milk, yeah? It tastes just like milk before one.
Is there any sugar?
No sugar either.
No sugar?
The Brown girls have little hope for Jade.
I don't think Jade is very happy with the situation. No, she seems a bit shocked.
As the families head to bed under one tent, the reality of the next few days is a worry for some.
Yeah.
It's not a holiday.
And I haven't had a drink. This isn't a holiday.
I want to go home tomorrow, I think.
Coming up, Sharon finds food preparation challenging.
Oh, what's that?
And a storm hits the camp.
I'm frozen here.
The Upper East Siders go gaga for a new lady in town. Straight from the US, Gossip Girl, Wednesday at 8, ITV2.
Bacardi Mojito, the original mojito.
Everybody loves Rob Ryder.
Hey!
Live on stage on his hilarious sellout tour.
I'm no great shakes in the bedroom. I know, it's a shocker, isn't it? I'm what women call a disappointment.
It's a show not to be missed.
Living the dream.
Rob Ryder live on DVD now.
At Asda, get Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince on DVD for just £6.71. That's a magical treat for the whole family. Asda, saving you money all the way to Christmas.
I don't want to take 300,000 same old pictures that break my hard drive. I want to take three that break my heart. Don't be a tourist.
Some things are too good to miss. Like the Xbox 360 Elite, with an extra wireless controller and four free games, including FIFA 10, all for £199.99, saving over £130. Pop in before Wednesday the 9th to get yours. Love Christmas. HMV.
The Mail on Sunday presents The Three Tenors Christmas. Pavarotti, Domingo and Carreras. Free CD inside tomorrow's Mail on Sunday.
Black Excess for her. Fragrances by Paco Rabanne.
Critics are calling The Descent Part 2 nerve-shredding. Tense and utterly terrifying. The Descent Part 2.
Raining cats and dogs out there. Dad, what are you doing? Giving dinner the octo factor. Sprinkles of this should give it loads of flavor.
Jinx, what are you doing?
Kitty's wobble and I'm just trying to give her the octo factor.
Give more for less this Christmas with Currys. With deals like this Acer laptop, only £349. Featuring an AMD Athlon dual-core processor with 3GB memory and £100 off. Or it's free when you sign up to mobile broadband in-store or online. Currys, we can help.
At Homebase, we've real Christmas trees from only £9.99. For Christmas sparkle, just add Homebase.
You don't need longer than this commercial to make a perfect Bacardi Mojito. New Bacardi Mojito. Ready to serve.
At Asda, get these DVD box sets for under £40. There'll definitely be something good on telly this Christmas. Asda, saving you money all the way to Christmas.
It's Mamma Mia, bigger than ever, in a two-disc special edition DVD. The nation's favourite, now packed with even more, including a bonus sing-along feature, brand new extras, a behind-the-scenes documentary, and interviews with the cast. The Mamma Mia two-disc special edition. Buy the perfect gift this Christmas.
With ITV Player, you'll never have to miss out on any of the drama from the jungle. Watch full episodes of I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here anytime you want at itv.com/ITV Player. ITV Player, amazing telly you can't miss.
For one night only, this is Rod Stewart!
Performing a selection of personal favourites and classic hits. And joined by some very special guests. Ben Shepherd hosts an evening with Rod Stewart. One night only, tonight at 9:30, ITV1.
It's 6 a.m. on the first full day of the holiday, and the Hardy Brown girls have already set to work on the first task of the day, getting the fire going. Some, however, are not morning people, especially when there's no ensuite bathroom.
We didn't sleep very well last night, Jay, did we?
No.
So we're just getting up to the toilet now, because we haven't been all night.
Oh, my God. Let him look in there, Mum. Oh, that is disgusting. Oh, and it stinks as well. We haven't done number twos yet, and I'm holding it back. Yeah, I haven't done number two yet, but someone else don't. Bless, stinks.
Morning. Good night.
Today's breakfast, freshly caught trout, has been provided, but in the wild, food doesn't come pre-packaged. The families must skin and gut all meals themselves. For the Brown girls, this is no big deal, but for the Maybes, it's a huge challenge.
Now, you got the worst bit, but it ain't that bad. It's the guts.
Not wanting to be upstaged by three young girls, John Maybe urges his family on.
Yeah, nah. You play down.
Nah.
Come on, do it. Tarts. Are you man or mouse?
With his dad's encouragement, 18-year-old Bobby reluctantly gets stuck in.
Right in. Both of your fingers, just get him in. Grab whatever you can grab. Pull it.
But his younger sister is having none of it.
I don't mind fish to eat, but not to prepare. It was a bit gruesome, and even though I've washed my hands in the stream, they stink. So I'll just stink everywhere. And...
It's 2 p.m. and breakfast is still not cooked. On a survival holiday, there's only time for two meals a day, and the families are starving.
A bit down, not a lot to eat. I eat three meals a day, and a lot in between. So it's a big difference from what I'm eating now.
Hey, Joe, I think yours is done, girl. You want to have a go? Or you want to try it?
I'm starving as well. No, I'm not eating.
Anyone want to try it?
Everything's so different that you do. I mean, chopping fire was great fun. Filleting the fish is brilliant. They're really working hard, and they're getting a lot out of it, which I think is great, you know.
Oh, that's the back, isn't
it?
The bone.
Tastes all right. But you're hungry, so you ought to eat.
Anyone got any salt? Salt, anyone?
Fussy eater Jade goes without breakfast.
Mm-hmm. So let's go and get the shelter done now, because it's getting dark.
With the food out of the way, the next task is to build shelter. Last night, they enjoyed the luxury of ready-made accommodation, but today, each family has to build their own.
Sort out the materials.
Let's go for it.
Survival novices John and Bob must make a shelter that will sleep the entire Maybe family. Equipped with a bit of tarpaulin and 10 yards of string, they have only their common sense to rely on.
Right, kind of Bob. We'll go find a tree.
Old pros Stuart and Jackie Brown have years of experience to guide them, and they've a lot to prove.
The wind's coming in from that way, the man.
There's always an element of competitiveness.
Yeah,
so who can finish first and get a cup of tea first?
But it's not just a race against each other. With a storm forecast and darkness approaching, it's a race against time.
It's funny, this ain't long enough.
The Maybes are not off to a good start.
I'll bring it.
We could keep this and move further down.
Where?
Over down there.
Where? Go and find the spot. It's too short. And now it's trying to bring it on me.
While the Maybe men squabble about the best way to build their shelter,
Well, it is a bit of firewood anyway.
Jade has given up and seeks comfort from 8-year-old survival veteran Beth Brown.
I just want to go home. It's not a holiday, it's a forest. Oh, it's cold.
We all have our low points, don't we? I mean, up on my low point, because I've wonder, last time we came, I was absolutely perished. Made a new friend today. Made friends with JD. This holiday is a stressful, hard holiday. And, I mean, it isn't a normal one for people that go in hot places because it's quite cold here.
Stuart Brown's enthusiasm for the Outward Bounds, however, knows no bounds.
What I like about this is you look at things in a different way. Instead of just seeing branches and twigs about, you look at them as forms of heating, forms of shelter. So it gets your mind working, which is relaxing in a way. Especially when you've got a big chopper in your hand. I must admit, I've got a thumping headache at the moment. But you don't notice it when you're doing this. It takes your mind off it.
You can't do this in your back garden, can you?
Well, I honestly don't know how. I'm still laughing doing this. I hope to God I never do it again.
Housewife Sharon creates some normality by tackling the domestic duties.
It's a dirty holiday, but kitchen's clean, so I'm all right now. This isn't a holiday. Do this at home.
The shelter competition is hotting up. The maybe men have drawn on a simple design. With the tarpaulin stretched between two trees, they've made remarkable progress.
I've never made a survival shelter before. I don't even know if this is one. But it looks good, I'm pleased with it anyway.
Oh, I'm impressed. I'm very impressed.
The Browns have adopted a much more intricate design and have fallen behind. Little do they know, the maybe shelter is finished.
We'll shoot down and have a look at the competition, see how good theirs is. Got a fair. How you getting on? I'm done.
Excellent.
We did start at the same time, didn't we?
It looks less done than it is, actually.
They're still doing this. It'd be funny if they wake up in the morning soaking wet and we're nice and dry and warm.
It's 10 p.m, a full 3 hours later, and the Brown shelter is finally done.
It's finished. It's done. Yes.
There was no competition. I don't know, have you seen that one? It's about that big. It starts off about that big and goes about 2 foot. And if all five of them have got to squeeze in there.
Dinner is much like breakfast. It still needs to be skinned and gutted.
I've never skinned a rabbit before in my life. Can't say I really want to do it again.
Jade's spirits are low. She didn't eat breakfast, and she's decided that she will not be skinning or eating bunnies either.
It's the most hungry I've ever been in my life. No one's ever starved me like this. I'm just going to leave, really.
Have you got enough protein?
It's midnight before any food is ready to be served, and morale is low.
I'm past the stage of hunger now. I'm beyond it.
Is that enough?
I just slip one out, which one?
Yes, from its furry packet to the dining table. Yes, very, very happy. Everybody seems in good spirits at the moment, so it's pretty good. So quite happy.
I'm looking around at their kids, and I don't think one of them enjoys it. They sit around that fire like, the Browns wanted boys rather than girls, to be true. So, dude, this isn't a girl thing. It really ain't a bloke thing. You've got to be a bit of a nutter to do this, I think. Jay, she's not been too well today. She hasn't eaten a lot or drunk a lot, so I'm a bit worried about her.
I'm trying to grab it tonight. I've got it with rice. She doesn't like rice.
As the families head off to bed, the question is, will the shelters survive the storm?
This time we approached it differently, a bit more methodically than the previous time we came. But we've been fairly confident that it'll hold up. Left of the storm.
2 hours later, Stuart Brown's confidence is shattered when his family is rudely awakened by gale force winds and a leaky tent.
Hello!
Winds are picking up.
Meanwhile, the maybes are sound asleep.
Who
You get the fire on, get a cup of tea going.
Looks like quite a nice day.
Last night, there were sort of little gaps in the shelter. So Mum and Dad had to put these things over the holes, and it took forever, and I ended up crying, so I didn't have a good night at all.
Somebody's fallen in the night.
Some people wake up bright-eyed and bushy-tailed.
The stepwells all snuggled up with each other. I think they've done well with the tent. If that wind was really blustering, but we never felt it.
You can see it's steady strong. Good for another 10 years.
Morning, everybody.
With the shelters now firmly in place, the main priority of the day is finding food for dinner. Survival guide Alan decides it's time the group worked a bit harder and sets them a challenge, which should leave no one guessing what's for dinner.
Fantastic.
No, that's fantastic.
No.
If you hit it, I'll get you a dinner.
There's a challenge.
First up is Birmingham's very own answer to Robin Hood.
Right, no pressure, Stu.
OK, mate.
Our food is all on your shoulders.
His maid Marion is also wide of the mark.
Whoa. Right in the leg.
Yes, indeed.
But it's Stuart's first shot.
Thanks to the marksmanship of the 16-year-old beautician Jade Maybe, the families will be eating tonight. Armed with a compass and coordinates, all they have to do now is hunt for the deer that Alan has killed for them.
I don't want to find the deer first.
I think it's round here somewhere.
Here it is, found it!
The Maybe's winning streak continues.
That's a shame.
Wow. It's way too.
I feel like a warrior coming back with a kill for the village.
Like a seasoned pro, John Maybe embraces the challenge of skinning the deer.
Okay.
Bill.
They put me order in.
When they pull the fur down, it's just like, oh, I can't even talk about it. It was horrible. Horrible.
Ugh. I don't even eat meat anyway. I need chicken.
The deer skinning is something of a revelation for Bobby.
I just think it's quite amazing how people can survive on animals in the wild, isn't it? And how they get the meat out of it. I think it's weird.
Following several days of near starvation, Jade gives in to her hunger and eats the deer she won and her father skinned.
Tastes like beef, isn't it?
This is all, yeah.
I think I've overcome some fears with eating deer. Can't believe I've done that. But it tastes nice, actually.
For the Maybes, it's been a difficult week, but they've risen to the challenge and survived.
Skinning that deer, that was the worst thing. I've never done anything like that before in my life.
I can't believe you've done that.
Not anybody can do that.
I mean, Jodie didn't do too much because he was a bit ill. Sharon surprised me on what she's eaten and what else she's got stuck in. He surprised me, Bob, on what he's eaten.
I'm amazed with John. John's skinned a deer and Bob's chopped wood down from the tree. I mean, I've been really, really pleased with him. They've impressed me.
I mean, anything they've asked, we've actually at least tried, you know, so I don't even think we failed any of it, to be truthful. One stage we've done it better. No, not really.
I shan't say no.
Coming up, Jackie and Stuart find it hard to adjust to the Maybe's holiday.
I am feeling a little bit like I'm a prisoner in this hotel complex.
It does make you yearn for the woods.
Surviving in the jungle can do funny things.
It's called insane.
To our famous campmates.
A mixture of insanity and mania.
So sit back, relax, and laugh out loud. Add some of the tastiest.
I'm gonna read back gag movie.
Most memorable moments. In the history of I'm a Celebrity. Starting with Unforgettable Trials, Tuesday at 9 on ITV2.
Get your stubble just right with iTrim from Babyliss for Men. Its unique motorized lens selector has 30 precise settings half a millimeter apart for absolute precision, so you can have total control of your stubble. Well, maybe not total control. iTrim from Babyliss for Men, now with quick charge and shave ahead.
Everybody loves Rob Brydon.
Hey!
Live on stage on his hilarious sellout tour.
I'm no great shakes in the bedroom. I know, it's a shocker, isn't it? I'm what women call a disappointment.
It's a show not to be missed.
Living the dream.
Rob Brydon live on DVD now.
Everybody loves a DVD. Spandau Ballet are back live at the O2. All their classic hits in this spectacular 2009 show that brought a generation to its feet. Spandau Ballet, the Reformation Tour, live at the O2 on DVD now.
On DVD, American Pie presents...
No way.
The Book of Love.
Boys, this book is a powerful weapon.
I'm in.
With more babes. And more outrageous comedy. It's the hottest slice yet.
Why don't we go back to my place?
How about you save your breath?
On DVD Monday.
Lives in the ocean, big like a whale, eats boats!
Sir?
Articulate, the fast-talking description game.
Outstanding seats, Louise.
The acoustics should be first rate from here.
I hear this piece really pushes the boundaries of modern dance.
Quite. The choreography's innovative yet a la mode.
And inspired by the great Slobodan Rorovich.
Ah, yes. The chief director of the Grand Bulge.
I believe. Therefore I am. I am king.
The Fragrance for Men from Sean John.
My world is getting set for Christmas, so I nipped into PC World and picked up this 320GB portable hard drive for $44.99. It's small enough for my son to take with him wherever he goes. And for my daughter, this wireless HP printer, scanner and copier is perfect. Only $59.99, their lowest ever price. Then this stunning Dell netbook really caught my wife's eye. It's in her favourite colour and was only £249. My world is all wrapped up. Whatever your world, PC World.
At Halfords, we're packed with great savings, like up to 50% off our entire range of sat-nav. There's 50% off this Navagon, 50% off this Navman, 50% off this widescreen Navman with traffic alerts. Plus, you can reserve online and collect in-store. Up to 50% off all sat-nav at Halfords now.
Sudafed deals with the cause of congestion to help clear your breathing.
This week, it's 3 for 2 on all clothing and footwear at Littlewoods. And of course, you can split your payments into manageable bits.
You'd be hard-pushed to find better quality real Christmas trees anywhere else.
And starting at just £7.98, we don't think you'll find a better price either.
At Asda, get this 24-pack of Carling for just £10. Stock up for less this party season. Asda, saving you money all the way to Christmas.
On Blu-ray and DVD.
I'm here for your help.
This isn't my war.
It soon will be.
Transformers on Blu-ray and DVD now.
Make it a perfect Christmas with ITV2 Movies. Get out the decorations. Put up the tree.
Looks great.
Check the lights.
Gremlins, eh?
Do that last-minute shopping.
Just flowers browsing.
Remember, it's a season of goodwill, a time for togetherness, even if they are unwanted guests.
No, no, we're all in this together.
The turkey's in the oven.
Yeah, hot.
Don't spoil your appetite.
That's not a brilliant idea, is it?
Exchange presents.
You're going to like this.
What is it, a birdcage?
You never know.
Thanks, Dad.
You might get what you wish for.
Surprise.
Pull a cracker.
Bingo.
And you're ready for a feast. Have a drink and unwind.
I think we're all in for a very big treat.
Then settle back in front of the telly.
Oh, yeah.
High five.
Make it a perfect Christmas with ITV2 Movies this December.
It's the last morning of the Browns' holiday, and the families are up bright and early to break camp. The Mabies are impatient for their holiday to begin, and luckily for them, help is on its way.
Sort of flares out there, I know. We've got to go and have a look at this. It's so different.
Aesthetic we're going to hang up.
The families have flown to a nearby hotel to wash and change before continuing on to the second holiday destination.
Your holiday is now finally over.
Yes.
It's now time to go on our one, and you are going to spend 4 days with us in the sun in Lanzarote.
Oh, fantastic. Wow.
Excellent.
That sounds wonderful. That sounds wonderful.
Let's go.
Yeah, brilliant.
Let's go.
The families have arrived on the volcanic island of Lanzarote. But not all of the Browns seem excited.
What are you doing so far, then? Huh? Good?
Yeah. Just doesn't look right without grass.
No, it's hardly any of that.
The Browns and Mabies will be staying on the beach in a 4-star luxury hotel.
Ooh, very nice.
Very nice.
And balcony.
Oh, wow.
Ooh. Look at that. It's very...
Vegetation-free, grass-free.
Grass-free.
Yeah, very little grass.
From Scotland, which is so green and colourful at this time of the year.
It was particularly gorgeous.
And yet it's white buildings, green trees, black sand, so...
Totally opposite,
yeah,
in that
it
respect.
Is, yeah.
The girls, however, don't seem to mind the black sand.
It's nice.
I like
I like it.
Yeah.
Right. Right. Kind of. It's a lot different to where we've been before. So.
Dinner tonight is at one of the Mabies' favourite restaurants, an American themed rib shack.
Cheers, first of all.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy holiday.
Right. The rules are we tend to relax a lot, chill. We do like a drink when we're on holiday. We drink up to about possibly 40 quid each a night. Obviously, when we go out, we obviously want you to stay out with us, basically.
Yeah.
We don't want to be 12 o'clock and you go home and we're out till 3 or 4 or whatever. You've got to stay with us and enjoy the holiday with us.
You've done really
well.
You've
put so much into our holiday.
Yeah.
The least we can do is to go with you on yours. So you'll have us all the way. Don't worry about that.
Anyway, here's to our holiday. Good health and cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Have a good time.
Right, we've got a full rack of Chicago ribs.
Having barely eaten during the last week, they order a feast, but this time they don't have the skin and gut. And for dessert, serious drinking.
£40 each a night on drink is just a ridiculous amount of money, really, isn't it? They'd need to go to Alcoholics Anonymous at the end of that, wouldn't they?
I am fairly well inebriated in my present condition, having drunk possibly slightly more than I normally drink.
They will never ever, after this holiday, go on one of their holidays again. I'm telling you, because that was that wasn't holiday, that was punishment.
We have a very short branch the size of my finger in our bag, which he bought from Scotland, and it does make you yearn for the woods.
After a long lie-in, the families meet to hear the order of the day.
Right, today's activities are myself, Stuart and Bob are going to go off and play some golf today.
Nice one.
And Jackie and Sharon and Jodie and the girls are going to sit around the pool, chill out for a while and just do a bit of sunbathing.
I look forward to going to golf. I haven't played golf for a long, long time.
It's all about relaxing, doing things that you don't generally do at home, because you don't have time to do it.
Excellent, yeah. Well up for that.
Oh, I don't think they're too happy. Stuart's all right. I think it's just Jackie more than anything else. They're quite active, aren't they, so they've got to learn to just chill and relax. A lot of people are supposed to do along with it. I think they find it a bit hard to do that. I'm just looking at reactions, that's all. Body language. It didn't look good.
As Jackie reluctantly settles into a quiet day of sunbathing, the girls go wild in the pool.
was lucky, wasn't it?
It was a good shot.
Better than the archery. Tell you what, I haven't played for 16 years. That's the first ball I've hit in 16 years.
Oh, he's only spooned it.
While Sharon and the kids play, Jackie is finding it hard to relax.
I could not do 2 weeks of hotel in pool. I could not do 2 weeks of this. I would have to get out there.
But Stuart seems happy now that he's found a patch of grass.
Nice shot.
I'm really enjoying this, you know, with John and Bob's company. It's really, 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 really nice. I'm really enjoying it. And the girls will be enjoying themselves as well. Chilling out with their books.
We hope.
We hope.
Find out when we get back.
Cheers, John. Fantastic.
Well done, mate.
Good going. Okay. Thanks, mate.
Stuart's won the game of golf. Meanwhile, Jade decides it's time to give Lucy a bit of an Essex makeover.
Sunglasses?
Necklaces.
What?
No, you're more of a man.
Oh, that is lovely, that is.
Okay, normally, out of all of this, I'd pick up nothing. It's not really my stuff.
So when I was 14, same age as Lucy, I was very sociable, always going out with my friends, having a good fun. She doesn't want to look nice. I think it's because of her mum. So they brought her up to a, like, a wildlife, sort of boyish way.
Woo! Boo-boos!
It was funny because we'd got completely opposite tastes in everything. I expect she would try and get me stilettos and pink satin dresses and stuff.
Take me for a tattoo!
No tattoos. It's been nice just being somewhere that we can just lay there all day.
Do you want to get it?
No. I think anyone who's been on camping holidays could quite easily get used to a relaxing holiday like this.
Dinner tonight is another local delicacy, Chinese, and Jackie can't contain her excitement.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. What did you think of today?
It was really good fun.
I've enjoyed today.
Yeah, it was really good fun.
Jackie's bad mood hasn't gone unnoticed.
Love her moan up, Jackie. I mean, she is what she is. But ain't gonna stop me doing what I want to do, so. And it's my island. They got to come along and do what I want to do. So, she'll have to do it.
Oh, I'm having a hot flush.
Yeah.
While Jackie comes up with excuses to call it an early night...
Lucy, are you going to be OK staying up?
You don't want to go back?
I'm wide awake.
John ignores her and gets the party started. And he's got a lot more drinking in store. £40 worth. The Browns have never been to a nightclub before, but it doesn't take long for Stuart and the kids to let their hair down. It's 4 a.m. when the Maybes finally call it a night.
She's never been to a nightclub.
I can
and
tell.
And hang on, she's 41?
42, I can tell.
Never been to a nightclub?
No, I can tell.
Well, I'm not a clubby person either, but she's never been to a nightclub. Where's she been? Where's she been all these years?
When the family surface the next morning, John has got the perfect hangover cure. Water sports.
So do you want to do the banana boat first?
But Jackie has to do exactly what Sharon does on holiday, and today it's a day of pampering in the hotel compound.
I've not had a massage before.
So this song, opening up your pores and all that alcohol is now being released. It's all going. So you can top up this evening.
After the spa, Sharon and Jackie share a quiet cup of tea near the pool, but Jackie is restless.
How long are the others going to be?
The tea may be flowing, but the conversation isn't.
I am feeling a little bit like I'm a prisoner in this hotel complex. If this had been our holiday, but we would have seen the actual culture of Lanzarote, we would have got away from this complex and away from the English bars. It's not a surprise that we haven't met many Spanish people.
for the simple reason I think they've got more sense than to be in a place like this. It is probably our worst nightmare of a holiday, to be honest with you.
As Jackie contemplates her misery, the rest of the Browns are having a pretty good time.
That was even better. Did you go so fast? Like, woo! That was so fast. Oh, I'm a good friend.
I'd bet on the back with me, and we were just laughing and giggling all the way down.
Wicked, man. It's brilliant.
It's a completely different type of holiday to ours, and it's a really fun holiday. I'm really enjoying it.
Back at the hotel, Jade continues her makeover mission, and she's got a treat in store for the girls.
Tonight I'm going to give the girls a makeover, make them look good.
Jackie and Stu won't be happy about that.
Right, let's do this.
Oh my goodness.
So. You like boys?
Boys, not like men.
Who's only kissed any other boy?
Never snuffed no tongues, now.
When have you done it, Jade?
When I was about six.
Like, I was brought up in a different area too, so our lives will be different, so don't ask me no questions, things.
Don't bother to ask whether we've got boyfriends. We go to an all-girls school.
Oh, are you lesbians now? Oh, God. You do make me laugh.
With the transformation from tomboy to teenage girl complete, it's time to hit the town.
Done a good job there, Jade. They look lovely.
That is lovely.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think that's fair.
We're going to disco.
Coming up, Jackie finally gets a bit of the party spirit. And Jade and the Brown girls paint the town red.
Thank you very much.
The Upper East Siders go gaga for a new lady in town. Straight from the US, Gossip Girl, Wednesday at 8, ITV2.
A festive saving at Morrison's. These Mr. Kipling mince pies are buy one, get two free. Morrison's, Christmas savings for everyone.
On Planet 51, everything human is alien. Discover life on Planet 51.
Wherever you want to get to, Lloyds TSB is here to help you on your journey. Over the last year, we've helped more than 50,000 customers get a new mortgage and helped over 80,000 new businesses get off the ground. And helped over 6 million people save for what really matters to them. To find out how we can help you, come in and see us. Lloyds TSB, for the journey.
This Christmas at HMV, treat the people you love to two CDs for just £10. With Take That, The Circus. And Leona Lewis, Spirit, the deluxe edition. Choose from hundreds of CDs including Michael Bublé, Robbie Williams, N-Dubs, Whitney Houston and Pink Funhouse. Two for £10 on selected CDs. Love Christmas, HMV.
If you're single, you should know about eHarmony, a website for singles who want a lasting relationship. We match you on compatibility in areas like character, intellect, and values. It starts with your free personality profile, where you learn about yourself and who you're compatible with. Then you can review your matches absolutely free. Aren't you curious to see who you'd be matched with? Log on to eharmony.co.uk and review all your matches for free.
Meet Beardsmith with their debut album, A Family Christmas. members of GMTV's Britain's number one family present an album packed full of Christmas classics. Make your Christmas a family Christmas with Beardsmith, out Monday.
Have you tried switching it off and switching it on again?
Yeah, if you could switch it off, then switch it back on.
Switch it off
and on?
Yeah,
off, on.
Add a bit of spice to your lunch break with a KFC Hot Rods box meal. A fiery hot rod, cool herb sauce, fillet burger, fries, side and drink.
OK, take your tie off and then just whip it. I'm just kidding.
The KFC Hot Rods box meal, only £4.89.
Estee Lauder.
An unbelievable offer at Morrison's. This four-pack of Carlsberg is only £1. Yes, only £1. Don't miss this fantastic offer at Morrison's.
At Homebase, we've over 25 artificial Christmas trees and over 50 lights. And right now, they're all half price. For Christmas sparkle, just add Homebase.
Surviving in the jungle can do funny things to our famous cabmates.
It's called insane.
So sit back, relax, and laugh at some of the tastiest, most memorable moments in the history of I'm a Celebrity. Starting with Unforgettable Trials, Tuesday at 9 on ITV2. Make it a perfect Christmas with ITV2 Movies. Get out the decorations, put up the tree.
Looks great.
Check the lights.
Grandma, eh?
Do that last-minute shopping.
Just flowers browsing.
Remember, it's a season of goodwill, a time for togetherness, even if they are unwanted guests.
No, no, we're all in this together.
The turkey's in the oven.
It's hot.
Don't spoil your appetite.
That's not a brilliant idea, is it?
Exchange presents.
You're going to like this.
What is it, birdcage?
You never know.
Thanks, Dad.
You might get what you wish for.
Surprise.
Pull a cracker.
Bingo.
And you're ready for a feast. Have a drink and unwind.
I think we're all in for a very big treat.
Then settle back in front of the telly.
Oh, yeah.
High five.
Make it a perfect Christmas with ITV2 Movies this December.
It's the last night of the holiday, and John makes one last attempt to get Jackie and Stuart to truly let their hair down.
What's going to happen now is Mum's and Dad's going to go out and have a drink, and Jane and Bob are going to babysit for it. All up for that, yeah?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, good.
That's fine.
Yep, yeah. We're up for that. All right.
Smash it.
The Brands have never been out without their kids before. Jackie isn't happy, and she doesn't want Jade looking after her girls either.
I think it's a joke that their babysitter, Jade, isn't that?
There's an Irish bar up here. Let's go and check this out.
Is it the spirits?
We get a bar. Okay.
Actually, it's a bar.
Thank you very much.
The adult's night out is in full swing, but Jackie's thoughts are still with her absent kids. John has got the magic ingredient on hand to help her loosen up.
Tequila!
Which is soon followed by another. And another. And it's not long before the tonic has the desired effect.
One sip. Oh no, it's non-alcoholic.
Today I've had a brilliant day. I would really enjoy to do this holiday again.
Nice, lovely.
Me and when I'm older I'll probably come here if I have enough money.
Which holiday was best for you?
Well, the survival course was like an experience. This is an actual holiday.
Lucy has tasted the freedom Jade enjoys. And she wants her parents to give her the same.
When Jade told us that we'd be going out, just like us kids, I don't know, I was sort of excited, but I sort of feel as if I'm being treated younger. I don't really care, I'm half used to it, but still hating it.
We really enjoyed it, it's been great fun. Every minute's been a thrill.
Finally, Jackie lets go and embraces the Lanzarote spirit. It's the last day of the holiday, and the hard partying has finally taken its toll on Jackie and Stuart.
I've enjoyed it more than I expected.
I've sat by the pool, sat by the pool again, really.
Jackie's... I think she might have found it hard because she has to do what we say. She ain't got control of what she's going to do. We're telling her what time to get up, trying to go to bed, where to go this and that and da-da-da. And she's not that sort of person. I think she likes to do her own thing.
Jackie may not have enjoyed herself, but for Lucy, the holiday has been a voyage of discovery.
Knowing Jade and spending time with her has made me want a bit more independence. Mum and Dad, hopefully, when we get home, they will start just... backing off a bit.
Oh,
yeah, we've had a good time.
As they sit down to their final meal together, the families reflect on each other's holidays.
When I first got there and see you all dressed in your combat gear, I thought, what the are we doing? This is going to be my worst nightmare.
Do us a favour. Oh, you're having a laugh.
When it got explained to us all exactly what we was doing, I went, in my head, they'll last one night, and tomorrow morning, they're going home.
I was quite amazed at myself, and it was a good experience. The reason why I was down was because I was weak and I weren't eating properly and didn't feel up to anything, and I looked a state. But Beth kept on talking to me and cheering me up. Lovely girl.
We'd manage, but we didn't find it easy.
Yeah.
I was more surprised with Jane and Mum.
The worst one was that beer.
Fair play.
That was disgusting.
Oh, that's terrible, that is. That's... I've got all ghost pumps, yeah.
It's a thing I would never, ever have even thought about doing, but I'm glad I've done it.
Not in my wildest dreams.
I didn't do a poo for 4 days.
Neither did I.
Nor did I.
We've enjoyed it. We had some laughs.
Yeah, but see, the thing is, you're not drinkers, are you? So...
Yeah, I mean...
They haven't done bad.
I mean, I'll be honest, it's probably not the sort of thing we would do.
That was, I was going to ask that. You didn't have any question.
Yeah, yeah.
Would we do it?
No.
Possibly not.
No, I mean, not what, all of it. No. I wouldn't want to sit by the pool every day, but then I'm quite active.
But then I'll
But then we couldn't sit around a campfire every day.
No, that's right.
No, exactly.
That's right. One thing more than anything else that's come out of this holiday is the fantastic experience for the kids.
Have you enjoyed the nightlife?
Yeah, it's been fun.
We've had a good time. We've had a real good time.
I don't think they've been totally honest. I mean, what's the point in dressing something up and then making it sound good when it ain't, you know?
Thanks for the experience.
Really
it's lovely to meet you and your lovely family.
Likewise.
Yeah, likewise.
Going on living with them again? No.
We're thinking of going on another survival course next year. Perhaps you'd like to join us?
Your holiday was really you know that, didn't you? But we have taken something from it, as you can see. All the deers and everything in the neighbourhood, nothing's safe anymore. We also had a dog next door. Didn't stop barking. We end up skinning it. And by the way, still got the rabbit knife. Have you still got the rabbit knife?
Yeah, still got the rabbit knife.
But as I always say, bigger is better.
Hi, Jade! I really enjoyed it when you straightened my hair and did my makeup.
We know that you enjoyed our holiday more. We have much more fun. If you want to come with us next year, leave Mum and Dad behind, you can come with us.
It was too boring. I like to explore and I like to be doing something when I'm on holiday.
And I don't mean to rub it in, but my man built the tent better than your man. Bobby done it better than the girls. Even though Jodie didn't do anything, what can I say? Maybe's just done everything better.
Go maybes.
Go maybes.
Go maybes.
So it's semi-final week. Three boys, one girl, and they all really want to win now. Holly will be asking them all about it at 9:30 tonight. And to keep you busy between now and then, Planet's Funniest Animals is coming up next.